Hello and good morning and welcome to Pioneer Hangout! Yes, my name is Mark S. Cabrera.
And I'm Lorraine Velasco.
And this is the very first webcast live from Pioneer House Makati.
Yay! So our very first episode. So Mark, we have very interesting topics today and actually guests for today.
Yes, tama yan, Lorraine. That's the reason why with us this morning to give us the buzz of the week is Alan of our Marketing and Communication Services. So ano ba itong buzz of the week, Lorraine? Ano bang pag-uusapan natin
dito? Actually, ang buzz of the week will focus on headlines.
Headlines.
At Alan, ano ba yung mga headlines sa dalawa?
Teka lang, headlines ito that affects the insurance industry?
Yes. Okay, even sige. Investment industry.
Okay,
or
sige.
Or interesting things happening in the business world. In
interesting. Yeah. Okay, so okay. Alan, what is our buzz of the week? Number one.
Number one. Well, they say that the insurers are keen on grabbing a piece of the 1.7 trillion SDA.
SDA?
SDA.
Ano ba SDA, Mark?
Ah, abula na. SDA. Ano nga bang SDA, Lorraine? SDA
is... A special deposit account.
Yes.
I'm sure
yes.
We've heard of that, no?
Tama.
It's one of those funds used mm-hmm. by the central bank. So if SDA, if you're an SDA investor, what you do is you look for funds where you can put these funds in. One of those funds would be, probably give it to the, or not give, or invest it in the equity market.
Okay.
And some of that will be trickling down to the VULs that our agents are currently selling. So what will happen is, we as insurance companies or as agents can actually grab a piece of that 1.7 trillion pie.
So ibig sabihin kukunin nila yun for investment purposes. Yun ba yung ibig sabihin natin for that one? Okay,
so maghahanap sila and some of them will be investing it in insurance as well. So
aba, good market yan. Yeah, good market yan for our
financial
advisors.
Imagine we're talking about 1.7 trillion, Mark.
Hindi ko nga mabilang eh.
No.
Okay, sige. Anyway, so that's our first buzz of the week about the SDAs that insurers are very, very interested in. So what is our buzz of the week? Number two.
Number two. Do you know who the Pinoy tycoon, or which Pinoy tycoon made it to the Forbes richest list?
Danny Olanday?
Sorry, Bloomberg's world's richest list.
Danny Olanday?
Danny?
Hindi. No, I have no idea kung sino.
Medyo, no.
Mark Cabrera. Hindi rin.
No, hindi. Does it ring a bell?
Alan.
So, sino ba yan, Alan?
It's actually si Lolo. Lolo ko.
Wow.
No, si Lolo ko yung kanina.
Henry C. Yeah, he made it at number 72.
Number 72?
He's 88 years old and he still made it at number 72.
Wow.
With $13.3 billion net worth.
Is Henry C. the only Filipino in that list? Siya lang ba mag-isa?
Yes.
Okay. Which is topped by sinong number one?
Number one is of course the founder of Microsoft, Bill Gates.
Parang kilala natin nung pag-usapan.
Oh, close kami.
$72.9 billion yung net worth niya.
Wow, that's big.
If Henry C. is at 88 years old, guess who the youngest is and at what age?
Aha!
Para may idea ko.
Meron ka, wala.
Bigyan ko kayong clue.
Sige
nga. Anong
social
clue?
Media.
So,
we're
social...
We're talking about Facebook?
Facebook, okay. Yeah. The founder of Facebook, si Mark Zuckerberg.
Hindi Mark Cabrera.
No. Sorry, Mark. At 29 years old, made it. And he's even richer than Henry C.
At how much?
At $24.5 billion.
Wow! Okay,
a lot
so
of money.
That's the second buzz of the week. Yep. Henry C. making it in the list of Bloomberg's top 100. Yep. And what is our third buzz of the week?
Well, it's a bit connected to the second one. It's still about Bill Gates, but this time there's a huge shift in terms of in the tech industry.
And what
is that? Matunog si Apple, diba? Because of course you're
Apple.
Using an iPad, me too, and all these iPhones. Pero Microsoft gustong lumaban ulit.
Okay,
and,
so what's happening?
And what's happening is yung current CEO nila, si Steven Ballmer, is already stepping down and is giving the reins to someone else na hindi pa nila kilala.
So naghahanap sila ngayon ng CEO for Microsoft.
Si,
Sino? Si Danny Ulanday is
part of...
Oh, sige. We'll try to see later on. No? Pero may nahanap na ba sila, Alan, kung sinong bagong CEO?
Yung chismis is, yeah, yung CEO doon ng Ford or yung current CEO ng Nokia.
Oh.
So, which is, which was currently bought, which was just recently bought by Microsoft.
Okay, sige. So, Lorraine! Yeah.
Yes, for our buzz of the week, so initially, no, we talked about the FDA, the Special Deposit Account. So, of course, you want a piece of that. No? And then, buzz number two talked about Henry C. The top 100 sub Bloomberg.
And buzz number three!
And buzz number three talks about Microsoft looking for a new CEO.
Yay! Alright, so maraming salamat, Alan, for sharing with us these three headlines for our Buzz of the Week!
And of course, you watch out for more next episode.
Yes, dahil makakasama natin si Alan more. Episodes. Okay. Maraming salamat, Alan. And please, do watch for this next tip na ibibigay namin para sa inyong lahat.
Be ready for anything. Start an emergency fund equal to at least 3 months of your current income. Stay safe and secure always with Pioneer, your insurance. Log on to pioneer.com.ph for more financial and safety tips.
Okay, so sabi ko sa iyo, Mark, a very interesting episode natin ngayon. That's why today, or joining us today, is our first COT for 2013.
COT, mukhang ano yan ah, nakaka... duda ang ibig sabihin ng COT na
yes, yan. Yes, and okay, malalaman natin yan mamaya ano ba ang COT. But of course, our guest today is Miss Mai Victoriano. But before that...
Yes, before we introduce Mai and interview Mai later on, we have with us, yung kanina pa namin binabanggit na si Mr. Danny Ulanday.
Morning!
This time to talk about our next segment which we call...
Tech Talk.
Okay, Tech Talk. Ano ba meron dito sa Tech Talk na to, Lorraine?
Sa Tech Talk kasi, di ba, we hear a lot of words about insurance, about investment, pero hindi natin naiintindihan. So, Danny is here to share with us one word, no, or one concept at i-explain niya sa atin.
Ano alright, so let's give the floor to Mr. Danny Ulanday.
Thank you, Lorraine. Thank you, Mark. Tech Talk. So, ano yung word of late na maya-maya tinatanong sa atin ng mga agents, even mga clients, no, lately, ang lagi tinatanong lately is, ano ba yung quantitative easing? Wow. Or QE? You've heard of that?
Narinig.
Definitely, right? Narinig yung Mai, right? Quantitative easing or QE3.
I'm sure si Mai narinig yun.
QE3. So, okay. What is quantitative easing anyway? So, quantitative easing is a monetary policy being implemented by the central bank, okay, by infusing money into the economy with the objective of stimulating the economy and making it better.
Huwag mo kayong mag-alala, ita-translate niya in Tagalog.
Yeah.
Ang ibig sabihin ng binanggit mo?
In actual experience terms, no, okay. Medyo para mas madali may isip. Ang US po, ang Amerika ngayon, over the past couple of years, is under recession. Okay? Although nag-recover na sila, pero they've been under recession over the past couple of years. Mm-hmm. Now, because of that, bakit recession? Walang trabaho ang mga tao.
Yes.
Bakit walang mga trabaho ang mga tao? Nagli-layoff ang mga kumpanya. Bakit nagli-layoff ang kumpanya? Hindi kumikita. Bakit hindi kumikita? Walang bumibili ng mga produkto.
Okay.
Naiikot tayo ulit. Bakit walang bumibili ng produkto?
Dahil
walang trabaho ang mga tao. So, the government now tries to intervene and ang ginagawa nila, magsusupply sila ngayon ng pera sa economy.
So, the quantitative, kita mo, hindi ko mabanggit ang tama, diba? QE na lang. Magsusupply ng pera ngayon ang gobyerno.
Ang gobyerno. And they do that, Mark, ang ginagawa nila, bumibili ngayon ang central bank ng mga long-term instruments sa mga banko at mga private institutions. Mga bonds. Yung tinatawag natin, mga long-term bonds sa mga banks at saka private institutions. Now, itong mga banko ngayon at yung private institutions, since nasa kanila na yung pera, ipapasa nila ito ngayon sa public. Again, via what? Via loan. Papaloan nila ngayon sa mga Amerikano at a lower interest rates. Or pwedeng investment instruments din.
Okay.
So, yung public ngayon, may hawak ng pera.
Yes. And how much are we talking about here?
Actually, they started this in September 2012, wherein they started with $45 billion a month.
A month?
A month.
Wala akong naintindihan. $45 billion na
Anyway, so what happens now is since may pera na yung public, then the public starts buying, starts may ano na, nag-consume nila ngayon mga goods, and the other companies now na nalulugi,
nag-recover,
and they start hiring again mga tao, and before you know it, the economy now becomes better.
Ah, so ganun pala yung tinatawag natin na QE, quantitative.
Kaya siya tinawag na QE3, daw, baka matanong mo, Loreno, is because this is the third time that the US has done that since 2008. They did it first in 2008, then in 2010, and then again in September 2012. $45 billion, di ba, nag-start, pero right now, it's at $85 billion a month. Okay. So ang tanong siguro, Mark, eh ano ngayon?
Oo nga, tama. Ikaw nakatingin nga ako ngayon.
Ang question kasi is, ang latest news is nagtitaper raw. Tinitaper daw ngayon ng US government yung quantitative easing. Ibig sabihin, babawasan nila from $85 billion to $40 billion or to $65 billion, then to $40 billion, then eventually, mawawala na by 2014.
Okay.
May konting concern ang mga tao kasi baka hindi na baka magka-problema na naman ang ekonomiya, okay? Ang concern naman ng iba is, oy, mawawalan kami ng pera ngayon.
Tama.
Okay? So yung ibang mga investors na nag-invest sa ibang mga markets katulad ng Pilipinas, nagpo-pull out ngayon.
Okay.
Or nag-wait and see attitude
kung ano
sila.
Kung
ano mangyayari bago nila i-invest ulit. And as a final bit, even if there are news about the quantitative easing, huwag mag-alala, no, mga taga-Pioneer, even mga
bakit
kliyente natin.
Bakit hindi dapat mag-alala?
Because the next wave will be happening by 2014, okay? Meaning, by 2014, sinasabi na baka dyan mag-taper off, magsimula mag-taper off, kasi ngayon, tuloy pa rin.
Okay.
So, it's not going to affect the market, the stock market per se. But even in the Philippines, hindi rin tayo dapat matakot kasi despite all of these talks about the quantitative easing, hindi tayo masyado affected. Of late, itong mga nakaraang buwan, kasi fundamentally sound ang Pilipinas. Okay?
Wow!
Yun ang matanong. Yeah. Ano yung fundamentally sound?
That's good.
Oh, ang hirap ng mga terms dito. Talagang dapat si Daniel.
That's ang gagawin natin ngayon. Next week,
we'll
discuss what does fundamentally sound.
Wow!
Next week, pag-usapan natin ang QE4! Okay, maraming salamat.
Yes, thank you very much.
Thank you din. QE, or QE3 is all about. And I'm sure our guest here, Ms. Mai Victoriano, medyo alam na niya yun, no? Mm-hmm. Dahil nga, Lorraine, ano nga siya, sabi mo kanina?
Siya ay ang ating COT for 2013.
COT, Ms. Mai Victoriano, what is COT? Ano ba ibig sabihin ng COT in the first place?
Oh, before I answer your question, I'd like to say hi to everyone.
Yes! Oo nga naman pala. Yes! Let's give it a round of applause to Ms. Mai Victoriano. Yan. Okay, well, thank you for joining us here, by the way.
Okay, thank you for having me. First, while well, you
oh, tinatanong ko kung
ano yung COT.
Ito kasi nagsimula sa QE3.
Well, COT simply means court of the table.
Court of the table. Okay.
Pero bago ka maging court of the table, may mga requirements ba yan?
Yes. There is normally requirement for premium collected or commissions that are received by agents.
Uy, so by the way, bago ka mag-continue, palakpakan muna natin ulit si Mai because she is our first COT for 2013. Ayan, kasi nabanggit mo may mga requirements eh.
Yes.
Okay. So ano nga uli yung mga requirements bago ka maging COT?
Well, there is a first-tier premium requirement that should be collected by the agent.
Okay.
Or you have reach certain level amount of commissions.
So may amount na ina-target para mag-COT.
There's a production requirement in short that an agent has to achieve before you're able to get the COT or prior to COT is MDRT.
Ayun!
So first level.
Ayan na lang. Ano naman yung MDRT, madam?
MDRT stands for Million Dollar Round Table. So
Court of the Table, Million Dollar Round Table. Okay. Ang Million Dollar Round Table naman ay isang magandang mess.
It's actually an international organization
okay.
in which the top...
International.
Yeah, it's a prestigious organization,
yes.
I heard.
In which 5% of the financial advisors or insurance agents all over the world are a member of.
Wow. Only the 5%.
And take note, my is including that 5%.
Pero teka lang, nalilito na ako. So, dapat ba muna, ilang beses ka maging MDRT, tapos COT ka, ano ba yun?
No, actually, in the organization, there are actually 3 levels. Mm-hmm. The first level is MDRT.
Mm-hmm. MDRT ka muna.
Yes, and before you achieve COT, your production should have been, or the requirement that you're able to achieve is times 3 of that
times 3 of your production sa MDRT. Tapos ang next level, magiging ano ka na?
Is actually TOT or top of the table, which is double the requirement of
the COT. Ah, so MDRT times 3, COT times 2, TOT,
yes,
times whatever.
The TOT is normally the highest.
Ayun na yun! Wala na.
They haven't come up with a higher than TOT.
Oo, baka basta may table pa yan. Ano,
yes.
Okay. Baka DOT, Diamond Table. Ewan natin.
So, my question, how long have you been an MDRT member?
I have been in the member of the organization 4 years
now. Wow, four years na, no?
Sunod-sunod!
Yeah, oh. And in that 4 years, meron ka bang memorable experience that you'd like to share with us?
I'm sure kasi may travel yan, di ba? Oh. You go abroad, you attend convention,
yes,
tama ba?
The MDRT organization actually holds its annual convention abroad, normally either in North America or in the US.
Oh,
itself.
Okay.
So that's where you meet all the
other,
the top 5% of the
ano yan,
so
rubbing elbows with other
literal
MDRT.
it enhances I think your confidence as an agent, because you get to meet with really good or probably excellent agents where you can learn a lot from. Mm-hmm. And it really makes you proud to become part of the industry.
And they are also the creme de la creme of other countries, di ba?
Yes.
Tama? Okay.
And of course, you want to be in that diba? Group.
It reinforces your passion to do the selling of insurance, kasi you're together with all the other people who have been part of the organization. It gives you... you're able to talk about your own stories.
Yeah.
Sharing of stories, no, with other.
And talking about sharing of stories,
yes.
Before you reach, before you become an MDRT, no, or COT for this year, 2013, I'm sure may mga sacrifices along the way. So, ano ba yung mga sacrifices na yun?
Actually, when I joined the industry, it's really not more. I don't consider it as a sacrifice.
Good.
When I joined the industry, it's really more of, how do you call it? Voluntary on my part, because mm-hmm. I found out that being in the industry is really what I like to do. So it's not, I don't consider it as a sacrifice, because the moment you think that what you're doing or you're giving up something and you're sacrificing something, is you eventually you'll tend to not like what you're doing.
Mm-hmm.
So really, as far as I'm concerned, there shouldn't be any sacrifice mm-hmm. involved if you want to become part of the industry, because I didn't sacrifice
mm-hmm.
my family time, I didn't sacrifice family mm-hmm. or my social life, anything. It's all part of being an insurance agent.
Yeah. And talk about passion, no? Kitang-kita mo kay Mai yung kanyang passion. And since because of that passion, marami mm-hmm. ka na-inspire, so would you like to give us some selling tips?
Oo, kasi diba marami dyan from MDRT, COT, tapos ilang oras ka nalang malapit na
maging
TOT?
Oras?
Oras
na lang ang pinag-uusapan.
Anyway, sige, tips! Ano bang maibibigyan natin na tips to our viewers?
Well, I can only think of 3 major selling tips, mm-hmm. if you may
okay.
want to call it.
Sure.
And since we're into acronyms, I'd like to
call my tips.
May acronym din yung
wow,
selling tips. It's triple K. KKK.
Triple K.
Okay. And the first K actually stands for know your client.
Know your client.
That's the first tip.
The first one.
It's very important for an agent to be able to get to know the client.
Mm-hmm.
Better if, before going to the client, kilala mo na siya. You have an idea of who she is, who he is. You've made some research about his company,
about the person.
Mm-hmm. So it's easier to build rapport, because you know a lot about your client. And it's a sign of you being interested in him.
Correct. Okay.
So, and the client appreciates that. Okay.
Okay, so that's K number one. Know your client. What is your K number two?
Number two, of course, after knowing your client, I always call it weapon, knowing your product and your company.
Know your weapon.
Know your product and the company.
Okay.
I think most of the questions that the client usually asks an agent is, so what are you selling?
Mm-hmm.
What is the product that you're selling? You should be able to answer the questions of the client about a product.
Correct.
The ins and outs, paikot-ikot kung ano yung tungkol sa produkto mo, and of course the company you're representing, because a lot of agents I think doesn't know the company that they're working for.
Mm-hmm.
So in fact I think in one of our usual sessions every beginning of the year, we're asked by our moderator to describe who Pioneer is
in one minute.
In a sentence, and you would notice that a lot of agents doesn't really know who Pioneer is. The most important things about Pioneer.
Isama natin yan sa tech talk ni Danny na
susunod.
Who is Pioneer? Pang tech talk natin yan para pandagdag dun sa key number 2. Okay, key number 3 naman, Miss Mai?
Number 3, it's keeping in touch with the client. So whether or not...
Keeping in touch.
Yes. So whether or not you're able to make a sale, it's always important to keep in touch with the client. Because if you're not able to make a sale today, by keeping in touch with the client, you always reminds him that you're there. So that when the need arises, he will actually, you'll be the top of mind of the client. Yes. And well, if on the other side, if you're able to make a sale, a lot of clients kasi ang complaint nila, ang complaints nila would always be yung after sales.
After sales service.
So if you're able to get the sale, the after sales service is very important. Tama. So keep in touch whether it's about the investment, about
anything
personal, anything. Just make them feel that you always remember them. Basically, those are the three tips.
Okay, right. So three selling tips for today from Miss Mai Victoriana.
Danny, anong tip number one?
Know your client.
Yes! Tip number two.
Know your product.
Yes, and the company that you're representing. Yeah. And of course, tip number three.
Keeping in touch
with your client. All right,
Lorraine? So very simple yet very inspiring. Again, thank you very much, Mai, for joining us today.
Maraming salamat, Ms. Mai Victoriano. And of course, Mr. Danny Olanday for joining us.
Thank you very much.
More of Danny next week on Tech Talk. And congratulations, Mai.
Thank you.
Ilang oras na lang, T.O.E. ka na. Okay,
so since we're talking about tips, we'll have more tips through this advertisement.
Eliminate wasteful purchases. When tempted to purchase an item you don't really need, step back and wait a few days before making a final decision. Stay safe and secure always with Pioneer, your insurance. Log on to pioneer.com.ph for more financial and safety tips.
All right, and that's the tip coming from Pioneer Your Insurance. And welcome back to our webcast, okay? Ngayon naman ho sa segment na ito, kasama natin ang mga kaibigan at colleagues natin mula sa Operations Department, Lorraine. Kaya nga, ang portion na to ay tinatawag natin na...
Update!
Yan, magbibigay sila ng update about the latest na nangyayari ngayon sa ating operations department. And with us, of course, is Miss
Shello Lotto.
Yes. Good morning, Shello.
Good morning, Mark. Good morning, Lorraine.
Welcome to Pioneer Hangout. Okay. Ano meron? Anong ops date natin?
Okay. For today, it is my honor to introduce the head of underwriting and policy issuance department, Attorney Reynaldo Paris.
Welcome, Attorney.
Hello,
so may bago tayong head para sa ano, isa sa mga how do you call it? Segment?
It's a department.
Department under the operations division.
Yes.
Okay, sige. How do we call attorney?
Oo nga.
Ano bang
Attorney Ray?
Attorney Ray na lang. Ray will do.
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 So Ray will do. Join. Attorney, seriously. Attorney Ray joined Pioneer on August 1, 2013.
Ah, this year.
Yes, this year.
Bago.
So, pero Attorney Ray, since when have you been with the insurance industry?
How long now?
How long? I've been with the insurance industry since 1996.
Okay,
matagal
na,
di ba? Ayoko na bilangin.
Matagal na akong underwriter.
Si attorney pala nandiyan. Okay, so 1996.
Okay, pero attorney, nung nag-join ka sa insurance industry, lawyer ka na ba?
Hindi pa. I started as an underwriter talaga.
Okay.
So, nag-aral ako ng law ng 2006.
Recent lang.
Hindi bilang ko ba ito? 1996, 2006. May ito sa 6 eh.
Yeah.
Okay.
And then, I graduated 2011.
Ah, 11 okay. naman yun.
I took the bar on the same year.
Wow.
Okay.
And then the results came out the following year, 2012.
Okay.
I passed.
Wow. Kaya hindi na Ray will do ang
pangalan. Yeah, dapat may attorney Ray na.
Yeah.
Okay,
attorney Ray na lang.
Yes.
Okay.
So, okay, attorney, so 'di ba 96? Pero
96.
What So nag-practice ka ng law since 2012
nung yes, nakuha for mo a year,
for, for a year. Pero what made you go back sa good, underwriting?
That's a very good question. Actually, I have three things to say bakit ako bumalik sa insurance industry. Number one, love ko talaga ang underwriting.
Wow! Wow. Well, very few people will say that, ha, that they love underwriting.
Kasi 1996, nandun na ako. Diba? Number two, magaling talaga yung convincing power ni Miss Bambi.
Ah, by the way, sino ba si Miss Bambi?
Sino ba?
Sino ba si Miss Bambi? Oh, oh. Mm-hmm.
Si Miss Bambi ay ang ating head ng operations division. Si Miss Barbara Bambi Foraganan.
That's right.
Okay.
And of course, number three, I am joining one of the top companies in the insurance industry.
Wow. Oh, you
which
know,
is Pioneer Life, di ba? Why not?
Meron tayo.
Di ba?
Galing,
and I think we're also very, Pioneer is very lucky to have Attorney Ray. Kasi yeah. Diba, hindi lang siya chief underwriter, lawyer, lawyer pa. Okay. So, Attorney, meron ka bang message para sa ating mga financial advisors?
Nako, oo. Kasi alam mo kasi pag sinabi nilang underwriting, mukhang medyo nakakatakot ba ang underwriting?
Oh, bibigyan ko ng requirement number one, yeah. Number two, number three.
Okay, yes, Attorney, any tips for our financial
siguro
advisors?
Siguro for now, I just like to say to them na ako naman very approachable person. Just get in touch with me.
Smile naman dyan. Ayan,
and I'll help you with your underwriting issues. Yun lang.
Ah, okay. So ayan, si Attorney Ray Paris. If you need to see him, punta lang kayo sa third floor that's ng right. Pioneer House Makati.
Tama.
Okay. Pero, pag tungkol sa underwriting, libre.
That's right, oh, libre.
Pag legal advice,
may bayad.
May bayad na.
At sa akin kayo dadaan.
So may manager.
Manager.
Okay, so we will be seeing more of Attorney Ray sa
yes,
Pioneer.
Syempre. And not just in Pioneer, probably from time to time, we'll be inviting him also here in our Pioneer Hangout to discuss probably some of the latest developments in the underwriting department. Mm. Alright, so
maraming, yeah. Okay, before we go,
I would like to
take the opportunity to promote yung latest promo namin sa CEC, sa Customer Engagement Center. Mm-hmm. It's a gift set promo of Private Iris comic books.
Wow! Ang dami, right? Ha?
So, bagay na bagay sa Pasko, ha?
Oo nga, Pasko. Ang dami.
For only 1,200, you get 20 comic books.
20 na kaagad? Oo,
20 comic books. Tapos meron pang, it comes with a free piggy bank and other goodies. And it comes dito sa ating reusable cloth bag.
Ah, this is for free. Libre
yes,
ka rin
to. Yes, of course. So, okay. So, ano siya, magandang, it's a perfect gift for your inaanaks, for your pamangkins, apos, this coming Christmas. So, punta lang kayo sa CEC and mag-order na kayo.
Shallow question, what about those in the provinces who would like to buy this one? Pwede rin ba silang bumili?
Okay, just contact us tapos para mag-order.
Ah, okay. So not necessarily sa head office lang ito sa ating third floor na CEC, but also nationwide po ang promo natin ito. So, Lorraine, di ba? Grab the opportunity now. It's only 1,200 and you get this. Okay. Lorraine, ayan.
Okay, so
maraming
yung ating update,
salamat.
Okay, next yes, episode, no? Sa abangan nila yan. Correct. Kasi they have another update for us.
Yes, and of course, baka samahan naman tayo ng mga bagong colleagues natin from the operations division. Alright, so, Lorraine, bago tayo magtapos ng ating first webcast for this year.
So, just to recap, no? Very exciting ang ating naging episode. We started with Buzz of the Week.
With Mr. Alan of our Marketing and Communication Services.
And then we also had our Tech Talk.
Yes.
From Danny.
Danny Olanday. And we had our guest financial advisor who is our first COT for this year, Miss Mai Victoriano.
And of course,
our Ops Day people from Operations Division, Miss Shelo Beltran Lontoc
and Attorney
Ray Paris. Welcome to Pioneer. Alright.
So, dapat Mark, abangan nila ang ating next episode dahil ang topic natin
will
focus on how to become successful even if you are working.
Ah, you mean to say kahit may trabaho ka from 8 a.m. to 5 p.m. kagaya natin, you can still become a successful financial advisor.
Yes, at posible pala yun.
Posible
so,
siya.
Watch out for that next episode.
And we'll have a guest also for that webcast. Alright, so guys, don't forget pala, no, our Facebook account. Lorraine, anong Facebook account natin?
At ating Facebook account ay facebook.com/pioneer
is your insurance. Huwag kalimutan kasi minsan hinahanap lang natin nila Pioneer Your Insurance. But it is facebook.com/pioneer is your insurance. Okay.
Okay, so I think it's time to say goodbye and see
for
you
now,
next year.
For goodbye now. For now. Okay, and this has been your Pioneer Hangout!